I just got home and I've been suspended from Twitter for harassing Barack Obama, but really I've been harassing the FBI about the lack of confession made by the Austin bomber, and I've said that Barack Obama was involved with the blackmail, or very involved. But now the FBI wants to talk to me, I don't want to talk to them, and so I don't know why they need to talk to me. Why don't you just go talk to yourself? That's why I'm contacting you, and then release the Austin bomber confession, which there is none. So, like, when you guys come talk to me, it's like, my first thought is, I don't trust you, and I don't particularly like you. Because, let's face it, when I was, like, what, 10 years old, you guys hacked my computer and put bestiality porn on my computer when I looked for animal pictures, and, like, when I was a kid, I got jumped at Riverview Park in Bakersfield. I mean, maybe that was just a coincidence. Maybe people do, like, little kids jump, like, just that jump means, like, getting hit from behind and, like, jumped on from behind, which I feel like most people think of jumped as getting jumped by a group of people, but I think of it as someone cheap shot you from behind and starts, like, wailing on you. But that might have been just a coincidence. I don't know how much people share with their kids about who sells drugs, but that probably was just a coincidence. But what I do know is that the FBI was giving people free drugs in Monument. That's for sure. I can give you names. Don't want to give you names. I do know that when I was at that hotel at Academy and I-25 with all these people that convinced me to run away from home when I was like 14 years old, and this like guy who was like 28 just started wailing on me, like punched me in the face. I can't imagine he wasn't an FBI agent because he started wailing on me and I was like 14 or 13 years old. And then my friend said, oh, he did that because he just got out of prison because that's why. But really he was an FBI agent who was mad at me because I think what happened is I beat up an FBI agent's kid. He was harassing me on the bus and he was just like constantly. And I told him, I said, if you don't shut up, I'm going to get off at your bus stop and I'm going to kick your ass. And I mean, he really was on me for like so long, and then I got off at his bus stop and I let him hit me 3 times and I broke his arm and I beat him up pretty bad. Like his face was bad. Like he was in the hospital. That was when I was like in eighth grade. So I think what happened is I didn't get in trouble because they had a bus recording of this guy harassing me and everyone knew this guy harassed me. So they kicked me off the bus. But then the older FBI agents got mad about me beating up this guy who was like a football player. I beat up a football player. And yeah, he was a year older than me. That's the thing about being a year older than people. If you've ever read the book, I think Malcolm Gladwell has a book about Canadian hockey players that if you're the oldest in your class, then you're the best. But the thing is, I was so good that I always played with people that were younger when I was a kid. And that's what I'm saying. Like, I still believe that the FBI, when I was in high school, like somehow, maybe it was my JV coach or the varsity coach, made sure that I couldn't be on the regular team. So it's like shameful when you're on the freshman team as a sophomore, especially when your dad got the same lessons as the Big Red Machine because he hung out with the same coaches. And your dad dedicated his life to trying to master the swing. He had a book like this thick, like a college tech, like a really big college textbook on how to hit a baseball. I swear to God. All right. So, there was also the time I got robbed at gunpoint during college. And I always say, and I know I said recently, like, there's a reason I theoretically should be racist because black people always commit violent crimes against my friends and I. Like, who's going to commit a violent crime? Probably a black person. Like, chances are, but then majority of the people I'm around are white. So, like, if I'm not ever around you, but when I'm around black people, they're committing violent crimes, that could psychologically make me be racist. But at the same time, I don't think I'm racist because, like I said, I'm not afraid of people because I'll kill you. But I do recognize that the violent crime rate amongst black Americans or black people, especially in the United States, is high. But that might have to do with poverty. But it's not as high with Mexicans, though. But that might also be because I think, like I've said, I think black people tend to be racist because of slavery. And they a lot, like, it's not all of them, obviously. But there are people that get racist because they think that, because they don't like white people. And so they want to commit a crime against them. All right, so the FBI, you know, who was this guy with the sword in Bakersfield? Because I'm hitchhiking through the desert. This guy picks me up. He brings me to his parents' house in Tehachapi. They're nice. And then he brings me to his house, and we're there. And then this guy is, like, smoking meth, and he's got a sword. Like, that. It was, like, thick. And he was definitely a cop type situation. And he kept walking back and forth. And then the other guy started calling me bitch over and over again. And so, like, I mean, the thing is, then there's the Austin Bomber. And then there's that one guy down the road who I'm at his house because I'm friends with his girlfriend. And then he tells me about how he got busted while he was stalking someone with a bunch of guns. And someone called the cops on him. And then he ran and left his guns behind. They found this bag full of guns. It had a 100-round magazine. It was like an AK-47, but a pistol. And then the people accused him of stalking people, but then they didn't even take away his guns. And then he gives me this gun. He says, "You want to see my Glock 22? I think it was, is that a 40 cal? I don't know. It's what all the cops have, I think, 40 cal. And so he says, "You want to see my Glock?" He hands it to me. I cock it, and there's a bullet in it. And I was like, "Dude, you gave me a loaded gun, and there's a small child in the room." And I was like, "Whoa, dude." And then I cleared it, and I just, like, I made sure the gun wouldn't shoot. I turned the corner, and he shoots a cap gun. I mean, like, all I'm saying is, like, I don't like the FBI. I think the FBI is mean. I think, like when I say you guys are like Mrs. Garrison, it's like, or Mr. Garrison, it's like you hate yourself. Like, you, like, are like us, but then you're not like us. And you want to be like us, but then you're not like us. So you, like, want to be like us. But then apparently half of you guys don't even know I exist. And now you want to come talk to me about me making threats against Barack Obama when I didn't. It's like, what, like, do you really think I just made a threat? No, you don't. Like, what should your real concern be? Like, me talking about China, killing Chinese spies. Because I feel like I should, like, if you, like, I didn't, like, when I left, no one, because I knew I had a feeling the FBI was coming. I didn't know who was coming, but I left. And, because I didn't want to talk to them. But I didn't know if they were going to come and give me an intelligence briefing on China or not. Like, but no, they wanted to talk to me about Bill Clinton. Oh yeah, what am I going to do? Like, oh yeah, I'm gonna Bill Clinton, I have a gun. I'm going to shoot you, Bill Clinton. Yeah, no, dude. I'm going to go shoot you in the forest while I'm hiking. It's like, what's the point of even talking to me unless you, like, actually have, like, real questions you'd like to ask? Like about, like, real issues. Like, who's this guy that put horse porn on my computer? I don't know. How old were you? Like, can you give us specifics about, like, the neighborhood you lived in, how long you were there? Like, that would give us a better idea about who would be hacking you and trying to get you to have such weird porn on your computer when your kid doesn't even look at porn. You're too young. It's before puberty. All right, so, yeah, I don't want to talk to you guys. Like, I don't understand why you're talking to me. Why aren't you, like, releasing the evidence? That's what I'm going to call you tomorrow and I'm gonna be like, "Hey, you want to talk to me? Where's the evidence?" That's what I'm going to say right away, pretty much. And then that's pretty much it.